Honor for the superintendent of Greenville County Schools. Today, the American Association of School Administrators announced its four finalists for National Superintendent of the Year, and Dr. Finnessy Fisher's name made the list. Getting Dr. Finnessy Fisher to sit down for a TV interview is not easy, but she said she wanted to do this for one reason.
And I think together we have made a statement as a community in Greenville that you really need to work together.
Dr. Fisher has been named one of four finalists for the 2011 American Association of School Administrators National Superintendent of the Year.
Wow, it was great. We sort of jumped up and down the halls here for a while.
The association credits Dr. Fisher for her vision and determination, which led to the construction of 70 schools, opening the state's first elementary school with a fully integrated engineering curriculum, and the fact that the district's diverse student population consistently outperforms their national peers on high-stake tests.
You know, our business is a good business when you think about children. And so when you really think about our mission, then we understand why we have to fight for dollars, why we have to save dollars, why we have to ask employees to make sacrifices.
Under the support and direction of the Greenville County School Board, Dr. Fisher has been able to do all of this during one of the toughest economic times in decades.
We've started our own professional development programs because we can't send teachers and principals to national conferences anymore, because we don't have the money to do it.
But she says this honor isn't about her. She says it's about the community.
We right now would only be able to fund the basics without the help of the corporate community.
Businesses, teachers, the school board, staff, and parents in Greenville County working together, making sure the students find one thing: success. Now, the three other finalists are superintendents in Kansas, California, and Washington State. The winner will be announced on February 17th at the National Conference on Education in Denver.